Hello everyone, I welcome you all at Smarty Education. Today we will be starting with Law of Dots lecture number 1 at Smarty Education. So before starting the video, if you want to join my WhatsApp group for getting latest updates and notes, please join my WhatsApp group. The number is given in the description box of video. So what are the topics we will be covering in this video of lecture number 1 of law relating to dot? Okay. First of all, we will see some example of law of dot and understand example of dot. How it is being implemented. Then we will study civil versus criminal wrong. Then we will study important definitions related to law of dot. Then we will see general condition for liability of dot. For what do you mean by general condition? Means the necessary condition in which law of dot will be applicable. So now let's discuss with the example of law of dot. For example, A owns a very nice house in India. A very nice house. It was the prettiest house I have ever seen in my life. Therefore, all people will be willing to see his house. So one day what happens that when A was not at his home, he is Mr. B, without his permission of A, came to visit his house and break a chair of A. After breaking the chair, B immediately ran off. Okay, when A get to know that B has done that, he asked B to pay damages, but B didn't pay. Then A went to court to claim damages. Okay, so before continuing our story, first of all, let me tell you, there are two things that you need to remember in this lecture. Tortfeasor means who will claim the damages, and tortfeasor means the defendant, means to whom a case is filed to pay damages. Tortfeasor means who will get damages, and tortfeasor means who will pay damages. So now let's continue our story. So the court finally asked B to compensate A for damaging his chair, as even he said that Mr. B said that he mistakenly broke the chair, but judges said whether intentionally or unintentionally, you have committed a wrong. Remember, you will have to pay damages under law of tort. So why am I emphasizing on this single words, law of tort? Okay, so basically tort includes all kinds of civil wrong in which someone has suffered damages from the act of someone else. In this case, due to B's mistakenly wrongful act, first of all, he entered into the property without permission of A. Then second of all, he broke the chair. Therefore, he had to pay damages for the wrongful acts committed by him. So I think you must all have developed a basic idea that what is tort. Tort means someone has done a wrongful act, and then he will have to pay damages to compensate that person so that that person can recover damages. Let's see another example. Okay, so in another example, what happens that due to lady's bad driving, she rammed into someone else's car. This is her car. So due to her bad driving, she rammed into someone else's car, and the man got injuries who was sitting in this car. Okay, man got injuries. So in this case, he is able to get damages claimed from this lady. So what happens that for the damage the lady has done to this person, the person is able to claim damages for whatever injuries he has got. Okay, so even in this situation, the lady was not intended to harm this person, but intentionally does for the wrongful act committed by her. Okay, so wrongful act means something which is an infringement of legal right, means someone has broke the legal right of someone. Okay, someone has broke the legal right of a person, so that the person whose legal right has been forbidden by someone, so he can recover damages. We will see that concept in the further explanation of video. Now you will be all wondering, sir, what is tort? So tort law is to the set of law means group of law that provide remedies to individuals who have suffered harm by the unreasonable acts of another. That we show in our example, B did a wrong committed act to broke A's chair unintentionally but had to pay damages due to his unreasonable act. And in the second example of accident, due to lady's bad driving, she rammed her car into someone else's car and the person got injuries who was sitting in that car. Okay. So, the law of tort is based on the idea that people are liable for the consequences of their action, whether intentional or accidental, whether they wanted to do or not, whether it is an accident, if they cause harm to another person or entity, for example, due to not focusing on driving someone injured, since even it was unintentional, but the victim can still claim damages. That we saw in our previous two examples. Now, let's discuss some important points relating to law of tort. The word tort is a French equivalent of English word wrong. Means tort means wrong, that I have ever said you in the beginning of the video. The word tort is derived from the Latin word tortum. Tortum. Remember, tortum is a very important thing that you need to remember. The simply stated tort means wrong. Remember this four word wrong being important. These are words which are very important because they have been asked in your ICSI mock test examination. But every wrongful or wrongful act is not a tort. Please try to understand that every wrongful act is not a tort. Dekho, tort, acha. So tort is a really kind of civil wrong as opposed to criminal wrong. So what are civil wrongs and what are criminal wrongs? We will see further in the video. But before that, we need to understand public or private wrong. So what are public wrongs? So, public wrongs are the violation of public law and hence amount to be offenses against the state. The best example of public wrong is murder, in which whole society will be affected. Violation of public law means murdering someone is a violation of public law. Then, in against the state means court will punish him. This is an example of public wrong. Okay, so what happens in private wrong? While private wrongs are the breaches of private law, i.e. wrong against individuals, public wrongs or crimes are those which are made punishable under the Indian Penal Code belonging to public law of group. So in private wrong, what happens that it has been committed to a particular person, not committed to a public policy. Okay. So in private wrong, what happens that, for example, when B damaged chair of Mr. A, this is in case of individual wrong. I hope you got the point. So this is private wrong. So now let's understand why public wrong. Okay. Public wrongs are the crimes are those which are made punishable under Indian Penal Code. So whatever public wrong you will commit, you will be held under public wrong under Indian Penal Code. Okay, under Indian Penal Law. So private wrongs are covered under law of tort or breach of contract. Okay, now let's understand civil wrongs versus criminal wrong. Very good example we will take here. In broad terms, crime involves community condemnation, means through the murder of someone, whole community will be affected, and punishment through the state means court. For example, a murder case in which this two girl and boy is affected from the murder of boy. Okay, now let's talk about civil wrong is a wrong against an individual that we saw in our A and B case. Okay, A and B case. Okay, so I hope you got the point. Civil wrong versus criminal wrong. What happens in civil wrong that a wrongful act has been committed to an individual that we saw in our A and B example. And criminal wrong means in which whole society will be affected and he will be held under against the state. Now let's talk about some important definition related to law of tort. First of all, in this situation, remember the names who have given definitions. Okay, Salmon, Fraser and Winfield. Salmon defines a civil wrong, for which civil wrong, I have already told you, civil wrongs means wrong committed to an individual for which remedy is common law action for unliquidated. Now there is a term called unliquidated damages. Unliquidated damages means the damages. Damages means, understand first of all, understand the meaning of damages in law. Damages means compensation, and unliquidated damages means the damages or compensation which is not fixed, which will be fixed by act of court and which is not exclusively breach of contract. I think you all know breach of contract, that there was Mr. A, there was Mr. B, they contracted it each other. Okay, B didn't supply the goods, so he will be held under contract, and as per contract, damages will be fixed and it will be called as liquidated damages. We will further understand the difference between tort and contract in the upcoming lectures. Okay, now let's talk about Fraser. Describe session infringement means infringement of a legal of a right in realm of private individual giving a right of compensation at the suit of injured party. Infringement means someone has stopped a right, means prevented a right. For example, in our case of A and B, B broke the chair, and first of all he broke the privacy by entering into A's property. Okay, it will be called an infringement of his privacy right. Now let's talk about Winfield. What does Winfield say? Tortious liability arises from the breach of duty primarily fixed by law. This duty towards person generally and its breaches is redressable by an action for unliquidated damages. Look, in all the definition, whether the words are different, but all have given the same definition. So from these three definitions, we can conclude two things. That a tort is a species of civil injury of wrong opposed to a criminal wrong. I have already told you difference between civil injury or criminal wrong. And second, that every single wrong is not a tort, that I have told you in the previous slide. Now let's understand general condition of liability for a tort. The first one is a wrongful act. There must be a wrongful act. In our examples, we saw that B has committed a wrongful act. First of all, he committed a wrongful act by entering into a private property. Then second of all, he destroyed the chair. He broke the chair. That is called a wrongful act. Now, the wrongful act resulting causing legal damages to other. First of all, legal damages to another means, first of all, B broke into A's property. First of all, he broke his legal right of property, means he entered into the property without his permission. And second of all, he faced the loss of his chair. Okay, then third of all, whatever wrong has been committed, there must be a legal remedy to provide to the plaintiff. So what does plaintiff means? Tortfeasor. Okay, now let's understand a wrongful act or omission of the defendant. Omission means mistake, whether it is a mistake or wrongful act of the defendant. So what does it say? The act complained of should under the circumstances be legally wrong as regards the party complaining. In other words, it should prejudicially affect any of the above mentioned interest and protected by the law. Thus, every person whose legal right is the right of reputation, right of bodily safety and freedom, and right to property are violated without legal excuse, has a right of action against the person who violated them, whether loss results from such violation or not. So I think you will be all bored to read this lengthy paragraph. So let me tell you what does it say. Wrongful act means wrongful act. First of all, it's a wrongful act. Wrongful act means, I have already told you, wrongful act means infringement of someone's legal right, whether it is an act of damaging someone's property or entering into some property without his permission. It will be called a wrongful act. And wrongful act will contain two things, civil wrong and criminal wrong. I have already told you difference between them. Okay. The act complained of should under the circumstances means it should be under law of tort, be legally wrongful as regards. This is the same thing. So the main thing that we need to focus on from here. Thus, every person whose legal rights such as right of reputation means, reputation means something in society. Right of bodily safety means someone's safety has been broken, means someone is abusing someone, and freedom and right to property are violated with the legal access and has a right of action against the person. For example, police entered your house without any kind of warrant. Then you can say that without any prior notice, they have violated my right. So the staff should be punished and pay damages to me, therefore they broke into my property. Okay, now let's go ahead. So the wrongful act must be in causing legal damages. Legal damages means, let's understand, it is not very every damage that is a damage in the eye of law. Okay, it must be damaged which the law recognizes as such. In other words, there should be legal injury or invention of the legal right. In the absence of an infringement of a legal right, an action doesn't lie. Also, where there is an infringement of a legal right, an action lies through the no damage may have been caused. Okay, so what is a legal damage? Legal damage refers to damage which has been caused to someone. In our example of A and B, A suffered damage. First damage is his right of privacy has been broken. The second damage is his chair has been broken by B. So there are two legal damages that are valid in eyes of law. Therefore, he got compensation. Okay. So what is not a legal damage? For example, I opened a school before you. Okay. You already are running school. So by opening of my school, you got losses, but you cannot sue me because you cannot sue me because this is not a legal damage under lies of law. So that's it for today's guys. I hope you all enjoyed the lecture. For joining the group, you can send me and text me on 7224075832. And for any query, text me. Okay, that's it for today. Hello everyone.